Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, dear students, assalamu alaikum. This is Yunus Khan and I am here with a new topic, that is pneumonia. Pneumonia and onward, some other diseases are usually the diseases of lower respiratory tract. Two diseases of upper respiratory tract have been discussed, sinusitis and otitis media. Now today we are going to start the disease of lower respiratory tract. One of them is pneumonia. Basically pneumonia, it is derived from two Greek words. There are two Greek words. One is pneumo, and the other one, that is ania. Pneumo means air passageway or alveoli. Air passageway or alveoli. As far as ania is concerned, ania is a word used for disease or infection. Disease or infection. So normally we can say that it is an infection of the air passageways or alveoli. Infection of the alveoli. Basically what happens here in this very disease, the alveolar walls are usually attacked by the different kind of germs, due to which some fluids and pus is released, and that is accumulated inside the alveoli. So whenever the alveoli is accumulated, is going to be filled with the accumulated fluids and pus, then at that condition inflammation of the alveolar walls is caused, and that inflammation results in pneumonia. So pneumonia is what? Hair accumulation of fluids or pus inside alveoli, as a result of which the alveolar walls is inflamed. Inflammation of alveolar walls is caused. So when such kind of actions are caused inside the lungs and inside the air passageways, then it is called as pneumonia. It is called as pneumonia. Now, further, the causes of the pneumonia, that may be bacteria or viruses. It may be caused by the viruses or bacteria. In case of viruses, if we look at the kind of virus, so one of them is influenza virus. This is a virus that causes influenza disease in our body. But influenza is somehow related in symptoms to the pneumonia, so that is also caused by the influenza virus. So influenza virus is usually the causal agent of the pneumonia. So therefore we can say that it may be caused by the viruses like influenza virus. Similarly, it can also be caused by different kind of bacteria. So different strains of the bacteria which are involved in the cause of the pneumonia. There may be Streptococcus pneumoniae, the main cause of the pneumonia. Streptococcus pneumoniae, this is a special kind of bacteria which is being involved in the cause of the pneumonia. Similarly, another one, there is Haemophilus influenza. So this is a bacteria which causes influenza like the influenza virus, but it is also involved in the cause of pneumonia. Okay, another thing, that is the mycoplasma, basically that kind of bacteria which have no cell wall. They are naked. These are naked and without cell wall. And it is said that when the mycoplasma is used and that is involved in the cause of pneumonia, it causes much severity. In this case, the pneumonia is very severe. Severe symptoms of pneumonia are appeared in the case of mycoplasma. Acha. Okay, now it may also be caused by the fungi and protozoans. Means other than these bacteria and viruses, some fungi and protozoans, unicellular organisms, they may also be involved in the cause of pneumonia. So these are different causes which are involved in the cause of pneumonia, because of which pneumonia is caused. Furthermore, different symptoms and signs through which we can identify and recognize the pneumonia disease, then maybe chills and shivering. Chill is caused and shivering is caused. Elevation of temperature is caused, because of which cold is felt. Similarly, high fever. The temperature is elevated, high temperature, high fever is caused. Chest pain. In this condition, is there is an attack of the pneumonia on the lungs and alveolar portion. So here what happens? A pain is felt here in the chest cavity or in the chest wall. So that is called as chest pain. Breathing difficulty. Due to the pneumonia, there is a difficulty being felt in breathing. Okay, so the patient cannot breathe properly. There is a difficulty in breathing. ATP formation stops. Either it stops or it is reduced. Okay, because of the reduction in the exchange of gases. Once the alveolar walls are inflamed and the alveoli are filled with pus and fluids, it results in the reduction of the exchange of gases. When there is less exchange of gases, less oxygen will be provided to the muscle cells. And if less oxygen is available to the muscle cells, as a result of which less respiration will take place, and that will happens in the production of less amount of energy. So therefore, we say that ATP formation either stops or it is reduced. When such symptoms are appeared, energy production is reduced, then weight loss will be caused. Because when there is less production of energy, the different fats and proteins inside our body are decomposed and they are broken down to produce the energy. So in this way, weight loss will be caused. Similarly, bluish lips are caused when the oxygen is provided to the skin and different parts of the body in lesser amount. As a result of that, a special condition is caused, because of which the skin becomes bluish. It may also be called as cyanosis. Cyanosis is caused. So here what happens? Bluish lips is caused because of less availability of oxygen. Similarly, coughing persistently. Persistent coughing is caused because of the alveolar attack. The patient starts coughing and he coughs persistently for a long time. Okay, similarly, along with that, when he coughs, during coughing, red-brown rusty sputum comes out. The sputum which is released from the body, which is produced here because of the fluids and pus accumulation, that sputum becomes rusty, red-brown. Why? Because some bleeding takes place inside the lungs, and that blood is brought out along with the sputum, because of which it becomes red brown or rusty in color. And lastly, during this condition, emphysema signs or symptoms of the emphysema disease are also appeared. What is emphysema? This will be discussed later on in a. It is a separate disease which have been given in your syllabus, so this will be discussed separately. So this is about the symptoms. When these kind of symptoms are available, this means this is pneumonia disease. Okay, now for further diagnosis, other than the symptoms, you can diagnose the disease with the help of these symptoms, as well as some of the different other diagnoses which are available with us. They are chest x-ray. We can take x-ray of the chest of the patient, and CBC means complete blood count. So with the help of these two kind of diagnosis methods, we can diagnose the disease, and as a result of which we can recognize and identify the pneumonia disease. Once the pneumonia disease is identified, that is recognized, so then we have to go towards the treatment, because it is very important. Otherwise, it will become very dangerous. Pneumonia disease becomes very dangerous. Sometimes it becomes fatal as well. So, in treatments, we must take aspirin for fever. There is high temperature and high fever. We have discussed in the symptoms. So, therefore, to reduce this fever, to control the fever, we have to take aspirin. Similarly, chest pain, like symptoms are appeared, so to reduce the pain, we have to use the painkillers, another one. Similarly, coughing, persistently coughing is caused, so cough syrup may also be taken. Similarly, we have discussed that what it may be caused by the bacteria. So once it is caused by bacteria, so we have to use antibacterial drugs, means antibiotics. So antibiotics can also be used. And lastly, we have also discussed that it may be caused by the viruses. So once there is a viral attack, we can use antiviral drugs. Antiviral drugs. So these are different kind of treatments. This is about the whole story of the pneumonia disease. If you people have any kind of question, you can ask me in comment section. Till next video, thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.